Speaking of radio, somebody who is the king of radio, many would argue, Rush Limbaugh joins us now on the
phone. No one would argue.
Good morning to you, Rush.
Hey, it's been a long time since I've been with you guys. How are you?
I know. Thanks so much for joining us. So much
My
to talk about.
Pleasure. Great to be here.
Well, thank you. Let's talk a little bit about Egypt, because we've been watching these live pictures come into Fox and Friends this morning of these massive protests going on. And I'm interested in knowing what your thoughts are. The Egyptian military apparently giving President Morsi 24 to 48 hours to basically not be president anymore in that country.
I don't know. I'm totally confused by Egypt. I thought this is what we wanted. I mean, when this all happened, when the Arab Spring was taking place a couple years ago, everybody was making it appear as though it was happening as a result of being inspired by Obama's own elections. A hope and change was spreading to the Middle East. And we had all kinds of learned people, including some conservative media pundits, talking about what a wonderful day it was in the Middle East. And this is exactly what Obama's presidency means. The world's going to love us. And basically what we have is a bunch of people in Egypt defrauded by an illegitimate lying campaign. Reminds me of some others that I know and familiar with.
Rush, it's amazing too. The Muslim Brotherhood had a chance to rule. The people saw it, the oppressive way and the way they dismiss women and rob them of their rights and their ability to succeed. And
wait,
now they're riding the streets.
What did anybody think was going to happen? Well, who are these people? I mean, they're not exactly the founding fathers of this country. What do people think they are? I mean, these are militant Islamists under the cover of a so-called moderate group called the Muslim Brotherhood. Well, I don't understand why anybody's surprised by any of this.
I don't either, and that's been sort of my point this morning, Rush, is what they voted this person in. They had other candidates who were on the ballot.
Well, but they were defrauded. They were lied to. The people of Egypt were lied to. They were lied to about Mubarak. They were lied to about what they were getting with Morsi, who's just a front for a bunch of more militant people. The fact that Obama can't even bring himself to condemn this ought to be eye-opening to anybody that's paying attention.
So, Russ, don't you think it's it would have been wiser before we continue sending billions and billions of dollars of aid to Egypt and F-16s and any other sort of military help they want, anything they ask for, we say, yeah, sure, go ahead. We should have found out whether or not this Muslim Brotherhood influence was going to be as Muslim Brotherhood-y as we suspected thought.
I don't mean to be a cynic, but I don't think what's happening here is surprising to anybody in the regime, the Obama regime. I don't think they're surprised by any of it. They're going to keep sending the jets. They're going to keep sending the money. They're going to keep providing the foreign aid. Nothing's going to change because of this. I don't even understand why people get so upset about this. This is so predictable. Everything that's happening here,
but
there are those who said this is exactly what's going to happen, and not just in Egypt. Go up to Turkey and go over to the Palestinian-Israeli conflict. This is a harbinger of what's coming, and we supported this. We helped install this.
What should
I'm
happen,
stunned
though?
That the Secretary of State is focusing on Israel and the Palestinians, which is Hamas. Why is he there? Even the New York Times said that's
it's
a sideshow.
It's John Kerry. He doesn't know what he's doing. Everything about this administration is image, sideshow, perception, photo op, optics. The Israeli-Palestinian conflict has been going on since the Bible was written. John Kerry doesn't have the answer to it. Nobody in this administration has the answer to it. The only way that conflict's ever going to be solved is like any other conflict is solved, and that is when there is an acknowledged loser who surrenders. Mm-hmm. And until that happens, all of this is just it's meaningless. It really is. I've been doing my radio show for 25 years, and topics now are starting to repeat, you guys. And nothing changes. This is all it's all part and parcel of the pattern of events. I mean, look at all the work Clinton and Arafat did. Why? It didn't matter a whit, did it? Look at all the work Jimmy Carter did. It didn't matter a whit, did it? Arafat was given everything he asked for at one point. He pulled out because he didn't want the conflict to end, just like certain leftists in this country don't want the conflicts they're involved in to end, because if you've solved the problem, there's no reason for them to exist anymore. So this is, all of this to me is just sadly, really sadly predictable. And I'm not trying to be cynical about it, but I am.
But at least with Mubarak, although he was a dictator, he was helpful to the United States in trying to at least try and find a peace process there. But let me ask you this. If you were advising the president, what would you do about these growing crowds in Cairo today?
I would do what Obama always does, and I would try to shift this and make it look like they're protesting because they're inspired by him. If I were Obama, I'd try to get myself into this story in such a way that it's all about me, because that's what he does with everything else.
All right, Russ, here's something that we haven't talked about. It probably hasn't repeated itself because it's brand new. Obamacare. Turns out that they're having problems selling Obamacare. In fact, they're having so much problems selling Obamacare, they're actually turning to school kids. They're turning to librarians. They're turning to the NFL, the NBA, et cetera. What about it, Russ? Can this thing survive?
Eric, it's going to survive. It's the law of the land. Now, I don't think it'll survive, but I think it's going to implode on itself. It's just unworkable. It is 2,200 pages of a brand new bureaucracy that transfers one-sixth of the economy to the government, which doesn't know how to run anything properly, particularly this one. The idea that, why are they selling it? Why are they, it's the law of the land. I'll tell you why they're selling it. It's because the 2014 midterms. Only 35% of the people approve or want Obamacare. 2010, the Democrats lost big. I mean, all the way down the ballot, the dog catcher at the local level. They lost big because of Obamacare. They are salivating at winning 2014, and that is why they're out there running campaigns for a bill that is already the law of the land that nobody can do anything about. They're trying to sell it. Yeah, I counter the negatives about it for the 2014 midterms.
Right. So, Rush, what you're saying essentially is that it's unimplementable. And if Republicans possibly were smart, who are against it, the Republicans that aren't, I believe everyone Republican is serving right now, they should back up and let someone try to work it, because it's nobody's program. It's a conglomeration of ideas.
I think it's, well, you're right. I think it's a golden opportunity for the Republicans to get back in people's good graces and stand for something the American people actually stand for, and that is their dislike for this. Look at what's happening to these exchanges, guys. I mean, you've been talking about it on your program this morning, the California Health Exchange. I mean, most people think that's where you're going to go to buy your health insurance if your employer doesn't provide it. Turns out it's going to be run by the SEIU, the AFL-CIO, Cover California, the NAACP. It's a Democrat voter registration group running the California Health Exchange. You show up to get your health insurance, they're going to register you as a Democrat. They're going to get you to the polls to vote on Election Day as a Democrat. They're using Obamacare and these exchanges to grow the Democrat Party. And the Republicans are sitting around twiddling their thumbs, worried about immigration and whether the Hispanics like it or not. They're being skunked on issue after issue after issue. Like, this is classic. The 2014 midterms are really, really important. If Democrats win the House, then there's no such thing as a lame duck last 2 years for Obama. He's going to clear sailing.
You think that's a possibility?
That the Democrats win the House 2014? Is that, because the Republicans are in the process of engaging in policies guaranteed to lose them elections. Absolute spot.
Speaking, you mean immigration?
Can I just point something out? Rush, the reason why they're selling this to young people is because if young people don't sign up for Obamacare, the thing will implode upon itself. They're the only thing that are going to be pillars to it.
No, no, if they don't sign up, they're going to be faced. The IRS is going to find them, and they're going to be fined. Now, the interesting number of the young people under 24, that I saw the other day, that the average annual expense for health care is like $800.
Yeah.
The minimum premium is going to be $5,500. That, I tell you, that's going to be another golden opportunity for the Republicans.
They'll
take
the fine.
Yeah, if they get out in front of it. But they will pay. The fine's going to be cheaper than that for a couple of years. But they will be found by the IRS, and they will have that fine deducted on their taxes if they have a job, which is another thing that fewer and fewer people have in this country.
Well, Rush, you have a big decision to make. You're a huge baseball fan. The All-Star game is going to be in New York. You know your way around this city.
Yeah.
Will you come up to New York City and possibly sit on our couch en route to going out to Citi Field for the All-Star game?
No, I don't go to New York during the work week because I get audited by the New York State. I've been audited every year since I left New York in 1997.
Wow.
And if I show up on a work day, then I get audited and they want, it's a hassle. No, I'm sadly frozen out of New York.
He's right. I'm going to try to move the game to Sunday.
I think if you spend 8 days in New York, you have to pay New York City taxes, or New York State taxes.
But if they move the All-Star game to Saturday, I'd be there.
All right.
I'm going to work on it.
Well, thank you so much for joining us on the phone, though. So maybe we'll talk to you during that week as well. Thank